Hey everyone, this is Vasavi Kumar and I am here to help you grow your business even if you lack confidence. Yes, you do not need to be the most confident person in the world to grow your business, but there are things that you need that can help you start or grow your business. Even if you're like, I don't really know if I have what it takes, even if you lack that confidence, I am proof that you can grow your business even if you lack confidence. My clients are proof that you can grow your business even if you lack confidence. So let's keep moving. My goal is to help you get the clarity, the focus, and the strategy you need to grow your business even if you lack confidence. Because at the end of the day, I want to show you that you can simplify how you spend your time, your energy, and your effort. A lot of times, we're just spinning all over the place and maybe you have an idea and you're like, I don't know where to begin. I'm not clear. Should I talk to this audience? I don't know what my message is. I don't know what I should be doing on a daily basis. Let me tell you right now, when you have clarity, focus, and strategy, you will become confident and you will become confident to grow that business of yours. It is not too late, even if you feel like you don't have the confidence. I'm here to tell you that when you have clarity, when you have focus, and when you have strategy, you can and you will grow your business. If you stay until the end, I'm going to show you exactly how you can be, do, and have anything that you want in your life and in your business, and you don't have to do it alone. I would not be where I am today if I had not asked for help and reached out for help and invested in myself. My clients wouldn't be where they are today if they had not reached out to me and really taken, put their pride aside and say, you know what? I don't know how to do this. Help me. So if you stay until the end, I'm going to show you exactly how you can be just like that and you can grow your business so you can stop talking about it and you could start being about it. There are a ton of life coaches, business gurus. I am very different than those life coaches and the business gurus out there. And here's why. First of all, I am a licensed therapist. I went to school at Columbia University. I have an Ivy League education. I spent my time getting a master's in social work. So I have been professionally trained and I am qualified to listen to what you have to say beneath the surface. I'm also a certified coach. I've been in business for 10 years. Everything that I am sharing with you comes from personal experience. I have never spent a dime on my marketing. So in the past 10 years, I have been on VH1. I was a lifestyle expert on Kansas City Live. I've been in publications such as Huffington Post, Mind Body Green, Wall Street Journal. I've been on Food Network. I've been on The Daily Love. There are many different publications when you Google me, tons of podcasts that I've been on, at least over 500 podcasts that I've been featured on in the past 10 years. I didn't spend a dime marketing myself. I am fully transparent, right? A lot of times you'll want to work with somebody and, but they won't really tell you what's going on behind the scenes. They'll kind of just give you this like general, you know, toolkit of things to do. You can ask me anything. I am fully transparent. And I'm like that because I want you to know what's going on behind the scenes of my business. And if you like the way that I'm doing something or the way that maybe you see somebody else doing, I will always try to give you the exact strategy that you need so you can move forward with focus and you can move forward with clarity. I'm an open book. You can ask me anything. If you have a question, ask me. That's gonna be your experience working with me. I'm not gonna hold back on my knowledge. I am here to help you grow your business, even if you lack confidence. Like I said, I teach from personal experience and I use a very customized approach with every client. Anything that I help you with, anything that I'm advising you to do, any sort of guidance that I'm giving you, any sort of strategy that I'm telling you comes from firsthand personal experience. If I don't know something, I'm going to tell you, I don't know how to do that, but I'll help you figure it out. I've done a lot of things right in my life and in my business. I've invested over $500,000 on coaches and mentors and online programs and workshops and conferences. I've invested a lot of money in my mind and in my business. I have been consistent in my message for the past 10 years, and I truly believe that when you know yourself, you can do, be, and have anything and want. Because when you know yourself, you're not distracted by everybody else. When you have focus, you know what you have? You have momentum. So for me, what I've done personally right in my life is that I'm a fast action taker. I ask for help whenever I need it. If I can't figure something out, I will always say to myself, what can I do to figure this out? I will ask someone, I will invest. I don't sit here spinning my wheels. So when I say to you, come to me and ask me for help, it's because I've done the same in my own life. And I encourage all my clients to do that. Don't sit there with your pride, feeling stupid or embarrassed to ask for help. You got to have, as Marie Forleo says, an everything is figure outable mentality. If you're up against a brick wall, you got to say, you know what? I'm going to be willing to do whatever it takes to figure this out so you can keep moving forward in your life and in your business. I've also done a lot of things wrong. If you have lacked confidence in your life or you still lack confidence when it comes to your business, you compare yourself a lot. You go on the internet, you look at other people's businesses, you look at other people's Instagram feeds, and you're like, they're better than me. Why can't I be like that? They're better than I am. I'm not good enough. Maybe you thought that there was only one way to do things because you follow all these people on the internet and you're like, I got to do it this way, or I got to do it this way, or this is just the way to do it. You've tried implementing all of your ideas at once. I've done that too. If you're a creative like me, you have a ton of ideas. I know that one of the things that I did wrong that really kept me stuck in the beginning of growing my business is that I wanted to do everything. I saw what everyone else was doing and I was like, I need to do all of it. And when I was trying to focus on all these other ideas, I was putting off all the little things in my business, you know, really creating those systems, really creating those processes in my life. So I didn't have a clear set of systems and processes because I was so focused on all these other things that I wasn't really looking at setting that foundation for my business. I didn't have a clear plan of action and I never really asked myself what I wanted. I kind of just looked at what everybody else was doing. Don't get me wrong. I think it's great to be inspired by what other people are doing. It's important that you distinguish between imitation and inspiration. You can like what somebody does, but you got to ask yourself, is this a good fit for me? Is this what I want to do? Does this feel good for me? I didn't really put my needs before other people. I was burnt out in my business in the past 5 years. I burnt out because I was taking on a lot of clients and I didn't really have good self-care habits. So I was trying to help the world and I was trying to save the world, but I really wasn't giving myself the time and attention that I needed to be solid within. If you're in a business or you are a service provider where you are there for other people and you're trying to help other people, you got to take care of yourself first. That was probably one of the biggest things that I did wrong was I didn't have good habits and I put others' needs ahead of mine. And as a result, I was always really trying to seek the approval from other people. I was just trying to look good. I was just trying to be validated by other people. I just wanted people to like me. And because I always just wanted people to like me, everything that I was sharing as far as content was what I thought people wanted me to say or what I thought people wanted to hear rather than really being true to myself and be like, well, what do I want to talk about? I had it all wrong. I was trying to create content that I thought would be well received by other people rather than being true to myself, taking the time to really ask myself, what do I want to talk about? Right? This is really all about showing up as yourself. If you are having difficulty right now growing your business and you lack that confidence, it's probably because you're not being true to yourself and you think you need to be like everybody else. And you don't, you just need to be like you. And that's why I really wanted to do this training because I wanted to show you that you can grow your business even if you lack confidence. And it takes that clarity about who you are and the clarity about what you want and then a focus as to where you're going and a clear strategy to show you how you're going to get. I discovered this the hard way. I've been in business for 10 years. It's taken me a very long time to really understand what it is that it takes to grow your business. But you get the cheap and you get the easy way. And I'm so happy that you're here because if there's anything that I can do is to spare you the pain of all the costly mistakes that I made, not only costly as far as financially, but the burnout that I went through to try to be this person and grow my business without really having structures and systems and processes in place, not only internally, but also within my business. The hard way is that maybe you've gotten too much feedback from people who haven't got a clue about your situation. Maybe you're talking to people who have never even started a business, or you're talking to people who are super cynical and negative. Stop trying to get feedback from people who haven't got a clue about their situation and have never even attempted to walk on the path that you're walking. You don't have a strategy. You're just like, maybe I'll do this. Maybe I'll do this. Maybe I'll do this. Listen, entrepreneurship really is throwing things against a wall. But let me tell you something. That's the hard way. Okay. The hard way is not having a strategy. That's why it's so important that when you're starting out or you're just trying to grow or there's an area of your life or business that you're like, I just don't know how to do this. See, admitting that to yourself is the first step, is to be like, I don't know how to do this and I need help. So when you don't know what you're doing, you don't have a strategy. And that's why it's important that you ask for the help. Maybe you're trying to change everything all at once. In your personal life, maybe you're like, man, I feel really sluggish. I need more energy. Or maybe in your business, you're like, I got to do my website. I got to do my social media content. I got to start pitching myself. I got to start, like, there's just so much going on and you're trying to change everything all at once. You're not taking care of yourself. You're not sleeping properly. You don't have proper boundaries. Your communication is kind of off because you're feeling really scattered. You're not talking to yourself kindly. You're irritable. You're anxious and you're trying to change your business. That is the hard way. That's why you need focus. That's why you need clarity. And that's why you need a strategy. If you have too many projects you're trying to juggle, you're trying to be in the media, you're trying to start writing blogs, you're trying to start doing videos, put out your content, making an invitation for people to work with you, developing a new product. You just have too much going on right now. And that's why it's so important that you really focus on the things that matter to you and that you're the most excited about. When you feel good about what you're doing, you raise your vibrational energy. When you raise your vibrational energy, you put that out there, you start to attract the people, places, and things that are going to support you in your life and in your business to move forward. Maybe the thing that you're really doing that's making this a lot harder for you than it needs to be is that you're trying to be like everybody else rather than honing in on your unique voice and message. I have a quick story to share. I was a morning show co-host here in Austin, Texas, of a lifestyle and entertainment show every morning, 7 a.m. I remember that it was really fun for me to be on TV. I loved being on live television, but the problem is that I was trying to sound like everybody else on TV. And I wasn't sounding like myself. And I had a lot of performance anxiety because I was not being Vasavi. I knew what I sounded like. Like, I've talked enough to know what I sound like, but I was trying to imitate other people rather than putting my own unique flair on it. When you're trying to be like somebody else, your body knows that you're not being like you. You know you're not being like you. And then you feel like a fake and you feel like a fraud and you struggle with imposter syndrome. After taking the hard way for 1 year, this is what I discovered. I want to first say this. I've been in business for 10 years. The hardest part of my business was starting from 2014. I had just gotten divorced. My personal life was a mess. Financially, I was making about $10,000 a month in my one-on-one coaching business, working with clients, but I developed an alcohol and a drug addiction. For I was doing really well in my business. I really had a firm foundation in my business, but my personal life became a mess. And that's why I'm really passionate about talking about this with you today, because I want you to know that you can grow your business even if you lack confidence and you don't need to burn out. That's the number one mistake that I had made in my business. I had the confidence, but what I didn't have was the time and the attention. I didn't give myself the time and the attention that I needed to be able to serve at the capacity that I wanted to serve. So after doing all these things the hard way, I spent this past year and a half really doing things the right way. And this is what I discovered. The more I put myself out there, the more my business grew. Because when people see you, the people can't forget you. And the more people see you, the more they're like, oh, I know who that is. You start putting out good content, people keep coming back to you. People are looking for a solution to their problems. The more I got clear on the problem that I was solving, the more clear I got on why I was doing what I was doing, who I was doing for, what I was sharing, and how I helped people, that really helped me get the confidence that I needed. When I shared what I wanted to share, rather than what I thought people wanted to hear, marketing and content creation actually became fun, because then I really started to hone in on my personality. My social media images and my social media content wasn't like, oh, I need to sound like this person, or I need my videos to sound like this person. I just started to be me. I just started writing like me, the way I talk to my friends, the way I talk to my clients behind closed doors or on the phone. I started to just show up as me. That's how you overcome imposter syndrome. You show up as yourself, no matter whether you're behind closed doors or you're out there on videos, wherever you are, you show up as the same person. I also learned that I could be productive without burning out. I realized that the little things that I was putting off in my own self-care and in my habits really made a huge difference. Hydrating first thing in the morning, going for 2 miles a day, going for a walk during in the morning, and then going again in the evening really made a huge difference. Stopping my work so I could pee and go to the bathroom and I could make myself lunch made a huge difference. I realized that I didn't have to burn out in order to be a boss and grow my business. I also realized that my ideas that I was leaving on the back burner were 100% worth pursuing. Not all of those ideas, but the ideas that really made a difference for me. And I gotta tell you, the last two things that really, really made a huge difference was that I realized that nothing was ever missing inside of me. And I want you to know this, you are not lacking anything. You don't have anything less than anybody else. You have everything you need inside of you right now to grow your business. And the number one confidence booster is to have clarity, focus, and to have strategy. And I'm going to help you get that. If you are ready and you want the easy way to grow your business and get results without losing focus, inspiration, and motivation,
can I get a hell yeah?
Woo, 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 woo. Okay, I'm excited because it's like, if somebody would have said this to me 10 years ago and been like, Vasavi, I'm going to give you the easy way. You don't have to get burnt out. You don't have to feel tired all the time. You don't have to be up till 3 a.m. working. You could still get momentum in your business. You can feel focused. You can have fun. I would have been like, please sign me up. So I want to give you the easy way to grow your business and get the results without losing that focus, that inspiration, and that motivation. In the past 3 months, I've made over $20,000 and I did not burn out in the process. This is huge for me because I always thought that in order to be successful, financially successful, and have and hit certain financial goals, that I had to burn out. I thought I had to be tired and exhausted in order to get money. But here's what I realized. When I prioritize my self-care, when I prioritize me, when I stay true to myself, when I have healthy self-care habits, when I take care of myself first, I can be, do, and have anything that I want. So I want you to know that you can be wildly successful in your business, whatever your financial goals are for you, and you don't have to burn out in the process. I won't let that happen to you because I know what that's like. And it doesn't feel good. When you burn out, you lose that creativity, you lose that focus, and you just feel like you want to give up. Results are not typical. All my clients know that they need to check in with me daily. They need to let me know how they're doing as far as their self-care is going. If they need something to talk about and get off their chest, that's where the therapist in me comes in. If they have questions on their business, as far as content, pitching themselves, speaking with confidence, shooting videos, writing captions, being true to their own unique voice, that's where my business strategy hat comes in. They use me for both. They use me not only for their minds and their hearts, but they also use me to be focused and clear and have a strategy in their business so they're not all over the place and they're not scattered. They're consistent. They're accountable to me. They have a I will do anything to figure out a mentality. They are committed to growing their business and taking care of themselves, and they are focused. I'm going to let you in on three secrets. The first secret is that you can make extra money or even more money without breaking the bank. When I was focused on exactly what I needed help with, I didn't have to scatter my money in all different places. These are the three secrets that I learned in my business. I also learned that I could be myself and attract the right audience. And I don't need to be like somebody else. I don't need to be like this person or that person. I can be Vasavi and I can attract the people that need to hear my message, that vibe with me. And I'm going to show you how I can help you with that. And the third secret that I learned was that I can create content that is aligned with my values. And so can you. Secret number one, I can make extra and more money without breaking the bank. When you are clear on your product, when you are clear on your service, when you are clear on the audience that you're trying to help, when you understand the problem that you are solving, so you're not just a life coach, or you're not just a personal trainer, or you're not just a realtor. What is the problem that you're solving for people? It's not just, oh, I sell houses, but think about the person that you're trying to help. Think about the value that you provide. Think about the people that have come to you in the past that you've helped. What did they come to you for? When you get really clear on that, you don't need to be spending your money on all these different programs and this and that to help you. You get really, really clear on you and what it is that you're providing. And then when it comes to putting content out there, putting education out there, putting tips out there, you're providing excellent value because you know the problem that you solve, you know the person that you're trying to help, and you understand why you've been put here and how you are the solution to somebody's problem. Content creation becomes that much easier. If we don't know these things about us and the problem that we're solving, we end up scattering our money in all these different products and services and online programs thinking this is going to be the thing that helps me. You don't need all that. You got to get clear on your product and service, who your audience is, understanding the problem that you solve. When you do that, you end up providing a lot of content that helps your audience, and they're going to want to work with you. They're going to want to buy from you. They're going to want to engage. They're going to want to be a part of your community. So that's the first secret, that you can make extra money or more money without breaking the bank. But these are the things that you need to do first. The second secret, I can be myself and attract the right audience. And at the end, I'm going to show you how I can help you do that. How do you be yourself and attract the right audience? Well, what's your message? If you had a big megaphone and you had 30 seconds to share a message with the entire world, what would it be? For me, that message has always been develop a solid relationship with yourself. When you do that, you can be, do, and have anything that you want, but you got to know your unique message. You got to stop trying to be relatable to other people, and you got to start being real. Not everyone is going to like you. You are not going to relate to everybody. When you spend your time trying to be liked by everyone and get everyone to follow you and like you and be friends with you or just think you're amazing, you're going to have to compromise parts of yourself. So the secret that I learned that I could be myself and attract the right audience, but it started with me being fully real and start showing up and really using my voice rather than trying to be liked and being relatable to everybody else. Once you do that, you can consistently put content out. A lot of the clients that I work with, and I'm like, well, when's the last time you shot a video? When's the last time you put a blog post out there? When's the last time you gave content to your audience? They're like, oh, I don't know. But when you know your voice, when you have found your voice and you have your unique message and you're just showing up as you, you're gonna come up with a lot of content because you're being true to yourself. When you're true to yourself, you realize that you actually have a lot more to say when you're not trying to be like everybody else. You can stop editing, you could stop filtering, you could stop being like, this isn't good enough, this doesn't sound right, or I shouldn't be saying this. You could just sound like you. You have a wealth of knowledge inside of you already, but you've been too busy comparing yourself to other people, trying to sound like everybody else, trying to be like this person, rather than really developing that solid relationship with yourself and showing up as you. I'm a huge believer in strategic storytelling. Stories are what gets people to want to know you more. It's what gets them to develop that trust with you. I know people that don't share anything about themselves, and I'm like, only share the good parts of you. I want to know what really goes on behind closed doors. And so I realize that when I'm storytelling and when I'm sharing genuine stories and authentic stories and things that have happened in my life that have gotten me to where I am, and I turn that around to give value to the audience, I realize that I attract the right people. Not everyone's going to like me. Not everyone's going to like you or relate to you. And that's okay, because at least you're being genuine and true to you. Secret number three, probably the best secret that I can share with you, is that you can grow your business without burning out. When you create a schedule to live by, it allows you freedom and flexibility. When you have certain routines in your life, self-care practices, you're actually supporting your creativity and flow. Then you won't burn out. When you have certain things in place to support your creativity and your flow, you can't get burnt out because you're doing things from the inside out. You are flowing from the inside out rather than pushing things and making things happen. When you're in flow and you're vibrating on a high energy level and wavelength, you can connect with people in your industry and audience. You're not going to feel less than, you're not going to feel small. You're going to feel good because you're taking care of yourself. When you take care of yourself, when you have that schedule, routines, and practices for you to really feel good from the inside out, reaching out to somebody in your industry or reaching out to a colleague or reaching out to someone you want to collaborate with will feel natural to you. You're not going to lack that confidence because you're going to feel good from the inside out. You're going to be alert and you're going to feel energized. No more pushing yourself to come up with things. You're going to feel good. When you feel good, you do good. But it starts from the inside out. And here's the thing, no matter how much information is out there, no matter what even I'm telling you right now, I want you to be able to trust your intuition. I want you to know that you have the answer inside of you. If someone comes to you with an idea, or maybe a potential client comes to you, I want you to be able to trust your intuition so much so that you know right away whether it's a hell yes or an absolute no. When you start to really feel good from the inside out, you do become confident in your skin. You become more clear. You become unshakable. And it really boils down to making self-care simple. There are so many tips and tricks and Instagram photos and images and advice on how to take care of yourself. But listen, at the end of the day, this is what I learned, is that it's my responsibility to really tap into myself and ask myself what I need. And I realized that when I didn't overthink how to take care of myself and I kept it super simple and I started building habits week after week after week, I had a routine. I had practices. I had structure that allows me to be this energetic right now with only one cup of coffee. You do not need to be drinking coffee throughout the day for this much energy. This energy right here is natural. This energy right here is from me really tapping into my values, my core message, and knowing that what I have to say is of something of value. And I want you to be able to have that, whether you're writing a blog post, on video, on stage, speaking live to people, on a sales call with a client, doing your marketing. I want you to feel so good that you can grow your business without having to burn the candle at both ends. But it boils down to finding those systems, finding certain technology apps, software that don't have to break the bank, by the way, but they help streamline your process. So those things in your life that you're doing over and over again, start thinking about how can I streamline this? How can I turn this into a system? Because what really is going to have you go from just being this one woman show and having to do everything is to rely on those technologies and rely on those systems to schedule everything and to create that content and to not always have to be on social media like, oh, I got to schedule this. There is technology out there to help you with that. But this is how you grow your business without burning out, is that you look at the ways that you can streamline the process. If there are ways that you can systematize what it is that you're doing without having to be repetitive and redundant and having to always be the one, and you use certain technology to help you, you're not going to burn out. You're going to have a system and you're going to be able to grow and continue to grow your business. My very dear client, Nicole Brenner, who is an interior designer here in Austin, Texas, and she works with clients virtually. Her company is Simply Design ATX. She came to me, she scheduled a call. We went back and forth a few times, but this past year, we finally got on the phone. She got really honest about how she was sabotaging herself. This is the thing, you gotta be honest with yourself to another human being, because our mind can play tricks on us and our mind can rationalize and justify the things that we do that are stopping us from moving forward in our life, right? So she got on the phone with me, someone who's been in the game for 10 years. She got honest about how she was sabotaging herself. She was open to my feedback. We talked about what she wanted and what she didn't want. And she's been working with me and continues to work with me to create that daily schedule for herself. She's a mom, she's a wife, she's a daughter, she's a business owner, and she's a woman who just wants to grow her business and to do the thing that she loves. And the first thing that we really looked at is, how can she do everything that she wants, not everything that she feels like she has to do, but everything that she truly wants, and still have time for her kids and her husband and her mom who lives with her and for herself, right? Because what she really realized was that she was burned out. She wasn't putting herself first. We created a 90-day strategy. She committed to daily action and with accountability with me every single day. She checks in with me every single day, if not multiple times a day. And now she doesn't hate working on her business. She's less irritable with her kids and her husband. She actually enjoys spending time with her kids, and she's not, you know, getting upset with them, because she's really doing the things that she has to do to take care of herself. She's definitely less scattered. She's way more focused. In fact, she'll check in with me and she'd be like, hey lady, I did this, and I did this. And I'm like, wow, good for you. Like, that's awesome. Like, she's taking accountability for herself and she's using me as her sounding board. And I'm there for her no matter what questions she may have about sales or marketing or her content. She reaches out to me. I'm there for her. I'm her sounding board. She prioritizes her exercise, her movement, getting in sunshine, her self-care. She has better boundaries. She's created and scheduled her content 30 days out before she didn't even know what she wanted to do. She completed her website. It took her about a month to really get her website like fully good to go, because she was balancing a lot of things, right? She's balancing herself, she's balancing her kids, being a mom, being a wife, but she was able to complete her website. This was in the first 30 days, create and schedule all of her content. And I put her in touch with a lot of my business connections and my colleagues in the industry here in Austin. So she's going to be speaking at virtual and live events. I've also gotten her in touch with people that I know outside of Austin, because in this day and age, you can do almost anything virtually. She's also reestablished connections with former clients and is getting new clients. She has new programs and services that she's offering to those clients. It doesn't just have to be face-to-face. She's also expanding her reach. And the thing that I'm the most happy about is that she's overcome her fear of being on video. So now she's creating videos and she's putting her face out there. She's putting her message, her voice out there to really help people simplify the design in their house so they can create a home that they love and feel comfortable and cozy in. So I want to ask you a question. In this past hour or so, would you agree that it's been time well spent so far? I know that I can't cover everything. Even if we had all day, I wouldn't be able to, because this really is a process. I'm trying to cover 10 years worth of information that I have in this webinar. And I said that I was going to give you a special offer so you can get everything you need to know so that you can start growing your business, even if you lack confidence. And if you act fast, I'm going to give you a very simple way to get started on growing your business. Are you ready to grow your business even if you lack confidence? Woo! Hope you're all saying yes right now. Yes! Are you ready to grow your business even if you lack confidence? I'd love to spare you the pain of making the same costly mistakes and give you the opportunity to work together. So all you need to do is right below, click on the button that invites you to book a call with me. I'm going to hop on the phone with you. You're going to have a form of questions that you're going to answer, and we're going to start diving deep into your business. I'm going to help you grow your business even if you lack confidence, using clarity, focus, and strategy so you can start being and doing and having anything that you want. And it starts with booking a call with me. I can't wait to learn more about you, and I can't wait to help you grow your business and for you to really build that confidence that is within. The world is waiting for you, and so am I. So go ahead and book your call below.